This video provides instructions for collecting water samples in stream and using the bucket sampler. Proper sample collection methods are essential to ensuring quality data with minimal variation in collection procedures. Before you begin collecting the sample, make sure to write the date and time on the sample bottles. When collecting a sample in stream, look for a spot in the water where the current is flowing. For creeks or streams, the middle is usually a perfect spot. Avoid collecting samples close to the water's edge or in stagnant pools. If there is no apparent flow, please check with an HRWC staff member if a sample should be collected. Make sure you are faced upstream with the water flowing directly at you. Wait for a few seconds to ensure all sediment from your steps has settled to the bottom. Now unscrew the cap, making sure not to touch the interior of the bottle or the bottle lip. Before collecting the sample, rinse out the bottle 3 times. When rinsing out the bottle, also rinse the cap and shake up for a few seconds. Ensure that following each rinse, you turn downstream to toss the water. Following the 3rd bottle rinse, collect the sample and return to the cooler. Take care to avoid collecting solid matter like leaves, algae, or organic matter. For the sterile cup used to collect E. coli samples, it is not necessary to rinse out the container prior to collecting the sample. If you're unable to take grab samples at your sampling location, use the bucket sampler to take samples off of a bridge or levee.
Similar to taking a grab sample, we must rinse out the sample bottle 3 times. Only when taking a bucket sample, also rinse out the bucket sampler 3 times before rinsing out bottles and prior to sample collection. When rinsing out the bottles, make sure to dump any water off the other side of the bridge or onto the road or in the grass to avoid disturbing sediment at the bottom of the river or stream.